In this video, I'm going to teach you all about IAM Identity Center. I'm going to help you understand what it is, what it can do for you, and how you can set it up. I will show you in the console how to build Identity Center and set it up for usage with multi-factor authentication, with groups, and with permission sets. The IAM Identity Center service has been around for a while, but it's been rebranded. It used to be called AWS Single Sign-On, SSO, and that's because that's primarily what it's useful for. It's great for providing single sign-on access, so you can federate with different identity providers. You can also integrate with different AWS accounts and organizations and business applications as well. So a great way to set up single sign-on and federated access. And they make it very easy for you with Identity Center. It was a little bit harder when we used the Identity and Access Management service. Now, it's worth noting that IAM has not gone away. It is still there. It's still very relevant and very useful. But Identity Center is very good for maybe the larger organizations and those that have those federation and single sign-on requirements. So let's get into it. I'll teach you about it first, then I'm going to show you how to use it. Okay, so I'm in the console. First thing to do is head over to AWS Organizations. Let's open that in a new tab. And here, I simply need to create an organization. It's really super simple. That's actually it. That's all we need to do. Now with organizations, we now get centralized billing. We have some features for adding accounts into the organization so we can have multiple accounts with central billing, centralized control, the ability to apply policies like service control policies. We're not going to do any of that today. All I want to do is just have the organization enabled so that we can integrate it with the Identity Center. So now I'm going to search for Identity Center. There it is, IAM Identity Center. So with Identity Center, again, the first thing we need to do, it's a simple one-click operation, is to enable Identity Center. Once it's enabled, we've now got some things to do. So we can create the centralized management configuration, and we can confirm our identity source, manage permissions, set up applications, and so on. So the first thing I want to do is come down here to where it says confirm your identity source. Let's click on confirm identity source. And here we've got actions. You can change the identity source if you're using an external directory system like Active Directory or an external identity provider. We've got the authentication tab. So this is where if you want to configure the multi-factor authentication settings for your Identity Center users, you can do that in here. And we have trusted token issuers and session settings. So the default session duration is 8 hours. Okay, I'm just going to leave that as it is. If we head over to management here, we have the option to create a delegated administrator and delete the Identity Center configuration if we've decided to stop using it. We're not going to do any of those things. So we're happy in this case to use the Identity Center directory. Note here that we have the access portal URL. Okay, so we're going to come back to that shortly. Let's go back up to the dashboard. So here it says manage permissions for multiple accounts. Let's click on this option and have a look at what it does here. So it's going to take us here where we can create things called permission sets. So if I go to create a permission set, we can use predefined or custom. I'm going to create a predefined permission set and I'm going to leave administrator access specified. Let's click on next. I'll leave the default, next again, and then create. Now I have a permission set for administrator access. As you can imagine, that has lots of permissions. The next thing I want to do is come to create another permission set, and I'm going to choose another predefined one, view only access, and then just next, and create. So now we have these two permission sets. If we go up to AWS accounts here, you can see that we already have that integration into AWS organizations. We can see the organizational structure right here. Let's come back up to the dashboard. So we've created a permission set. Now you can set up user and group assignments and configure multi-factor authentication if that's what you need to do. I'm going to go across to the on the left here and you can see we've got users, groups, and settings. Let's go to groups first and I'm going to create a group. I'm going to call this group management and then simply create that group. Next, I'm going to go to users and I'm going to create a user, provide a name. This one's going to be for me. You can add in an email address and confirm that email address. Once you've done that, enter the first name and last name, any other information that you want to supply, and click on next. Now we have the option to add the user to a group, so I'm going to add the user to the management group, and then click on Add User. Okay, so now I have a user account. Next, we're going to come back down to where it says Accounts, select the main account, this is the management account, click Assign Users or Groups. I'm going to assign the group management, click on Next, and then I'm going to assign these two permission sets. Click on Next again, and then Submit. You can see it's now configuring the account. Great, so now we have the administrator access and view only access permission sets. They are assigned to the account and via the group. And of course, the user is in the group. And we have our account set up. Now you should have received an email in the email address assigned to the user account with an accept invitation button. You'll want to click on accept invitation, and that should take you to a page much like this one, where you're going to set a new password. So I'm going to set a password. Let's set that password, and my account has been created. So now it's going to automatically take me to the login page. Let's put in the username, the password. By default, it's going to ask me to register an MFA device. So I'm going to click on Authenticator app. And what I'm going to do is just show a QR code. I've scanned the QR code, and I'm going to put in the first code that it's generated and click on Assign MFA. And that's it. I've registered an MFA device. Now I'm going to land on this page. If you have multiple accounts, you're going to see them here. I've just got one in my organization. So if I click on the button here, I see the account. If I click again, I now see the different permission sets that I have. So I've got administrator access and view only access. I can choose to go to the management console or the command line. So for example, why don't I use view only access and click on the management console button here. So that's going to take me on now with limited permissions. If I just want to have a look around, we can see in the top right hand corner here, it says view only access. So that is how we can log in with a permission set assigned to our account. If I come back now, I can go and log in as administrator. And now I'm logged in with full admin permissions. So if we come back, now it's going to ask me to reload here because now I'm logged in with a different account. But if we come back to Identity Center, on the dashboard here, this is the access portal. So you can always copy this and bookmark it. And that's how you can end up getting to that login screen where you can then choose your user account and choose how you want to log in, management console or command line, and which permission set you would like to use.